Such a great game. I'm so disappointed that the sequel is coming on the PSP and not on the PS3. So disappointed.
Maybe it's not. It doesn't seem like a sequel as much as like a spin-off to a series that does not yet have a sequel. So
yeah, I hope it's just a spin-off.
Still up in the air whether we have a sequel. Even if it is a sequel, it doesn't mean there couldn't be another sequel on the PS3.
That's true.
Hopefully they're still working on that, because yeah, the game's gonna be great. I want to play it.
No, because like what makes Valkyria Chronicles great for me is like the story and the cutscenes and the voice acting. Like on the PSP, like I'm not gonna get as much as that on the PSP.
I wonder if they'll still have the voice acting. And somehow
it's gonna suck.
It feels like it would suck. Well, it certainly suck if there's no way I could import it if I gotta have a ton of text to go through. Like screw that. It seems to be set for the end of this year in Japan, so now we're wondering. Now we have to wonder. It's like, are we going to get this at some point?
Probably not, then.
Let's see, I want to know, are there voice actors? Because that would be nice.
Yeah, that would be nice. I wonder how the graphics of the game would be, too, because, like Valkyrian Chronicles, what was really great was, you know, the canvas-style graphics. Just really great to look at.
Yeah.
On the PSP, I don't know how that could be translated.
What? Like the graphics and stuff? I think there's no reason these graphics are going to be pulled off, because it's not... It doesn't seem like it was a really intensive thing. It was just a really cool style.
I don't know. It seems pretty intensive.
It could be, but who knows? It's not... You know, we have PS2 power in the handheld. Who knows what they can do with that?
Yeah.
And it's a really low resolution, you know, relative to anything, because it's this, you know, small resolution, so there's no reason you can't get good graphics on that.
Well, I don't know. We shall see.
You will see, because, yes, as this guy says, Silvaria couldn't possibly be as awesome.
You get to control her, you know, did you ever get all A rank on all missions in Silvaria DLC?
All missions. There were two missions.
There were four.
Huh? Why are there four missions?
Oh, you don't know, dude. This is the first mission. If you destroy the tank, you get the mission is different from than getting an A rank.
Yeah, I know.
You get three missions like that, right? If you defeat. Yeah. If you destroy the tank, the next level is, you know, I don't know what it's called, but it's one level. If you get an A rank by completing it in three turns, then you get another level, so that's three missions.
No, well, it would actually be really easy to get there with an A rank, just screw the rest
and
of
then,
it.
And then you get an A rank for all three missions, and you get a fourth mission, which is, you get to play as Valkyria, you get to play as Silvaria in Valkyria form.
You actually had that then?
Yes. Okay. I wrote my YouTube review. I made my YouTube video review. I showed that off.
Yeah, I always forget to watch those.
Well, listen, go to the very end.
Like a save file from the beginning of the mission.
The what?
Oh. I'll just be like, okay, I'll just play this. Because you have to have like separate save files for it. You don't just have like a big story mode to use.
Right. I don't know if I can actually send you.
Yeah, you can copy it off the system and then go and like post it or whatever. I don't know.
It's pretty cool. I mean, it's pretty because you were so powerful at Silvaria. It's kind of too easy and kind of too boring. But it's just the feeling, like it's so awesome playing as actual Valkyria, the Silvaria. It's kick ass.
Yeah.
She is so powerful. She has two different weapons. I mean, she has that lance, but it can be used in two different ways. One is a long-range cannon blast. It charges up and it.
Right, I know. I remember those were the first. Those were the first videos they showed of that, and yeah, I completely forgot about that because I didn't play a mission where she had the lance and like her powers and stuff. I just played with, like that dude. The mission you had to get off the top of the fortress and then run down and save her in the trench, and that was like.
Yeah.
That mission was just terrible. Because after that, all you could do was like try to run with Silvaria and just hope you survive. But actually, then, you know,
well,
then...
getting to Silveria was the hardest part. Like, I had to figure so many things out to get that right. And, like, so many things messed up.
Get things right. No, you... Yeah, didn't I tell you what I did? I killed the sniper on the tower with a lancer.
Yeah, I don't know how you did that.
I got a headshot on him with a lancer from, like, a couple hundred feet away. And I'm like, wow, the chances of that ever working were, like, impossible. Actually, it worked the first time, but, of course, I did this a few times, so the next time, it took, like, three times before I got that to work.
Dude, I think I told you, but, you know that, the ace scout, yeah, the enemy scout, I didn't even know he was an ace, so the first time I played a level, I had a scout, I aimed a headshot at him, and I killed him. I was like, okay, that was easy. And then, but I had to reload that save because I messed something up. I tried the same thing. After like 20 times, that scout stayed alive. So I was like, okay, maybe I should have saved that the first time after I killed that guy. That guy's annoying. He has long range scout rifle, but his rifle power is so damaging.
The problem with that mission, if we're still talking about that mission, was not like... It wasn't even saving Sobari and then go finishing the mission with her. It was protecting your damn camp because they had like, you had a camp. You had to protect the base camp where no one's in it because they're all on top of the wall, and there's like an enemy camp about 10 feet from it, filled with like those super, like, officer type enemies that are like the type that cannot be killed.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, the
ace. Yeah, I know. It's not just the normal scout. It's the ace scout where you can't freaking kill that guy.
They're like, they have the firepower of shock troopers, the range of a sniper, and the, I don't know, just like a scout. So it's like the most powerful unit ever made against you.
Yeah, tank at least. So what I did was, like, it took the first turn, like, tank out and destroyed the enemy tank.
Yeah.
Then the thing was, they later came in with, like, a bunch of Lancers and destroyed my tank, and then there's no one freaking guarding the base, so I kept spawning in shock troopers.
See, that's the problem with that mission. The longer, more turns you take, the harder it gets.
More turns. I took 3 turns.
Oh. That's weird. I never had a problem with defending the base. The problem with me was getting to Silveria.
Getting to it? Well, yeah, because you have to get the crappy engineer there who dies in one shot.
Yeah, that was...
You have to get the movement really exact, but I managed to just get a shock trooper over there that, like, took out the guys in the trenches.
Oh, I didn't bother killing. I sniped one guy.
There's a shock trooper in the trench, like, a few feet from her that you have to kill.
Yeah, I don't know how I did it without killing that guy.
You can't kill her with that useless engineer guy. Oh, yeah, by the way, what was his name? They said, didn't say it was, like, Johans or something?
Yeah, Johans, yeah.
That was in the subtitle. Remember, I'm playing it with the Japanese track, which for some reason was in the DLC as well. His name was definitely Carl.
Yeah, Carl Johans.
What? Carl Johans?
Mm-hmm. Oops.
Okay. One, I never see that they give both names, because I'm just hearing everyone calling him Carl, and then the subtitle is saying Johans, and I'm like, that's not matching up too well. No, that's just the thing, because in, actually, it doesn't match up at all, because in with the whole formality of the language, you never call someone by their first name.
Yeah.
So Carl had to be his first name, and so they'd never be calling him like that, which is why the subtitle...
Oh, that is weird. Yeah, the Japanese wouldn't say first names.
The subtitle would have made more sense, and yes, unless Johans is somehow his first name, because that sounds like a first name, too. It's like, you got me all confused, because those are both first names.
Yeah, well, I'll have to double-check if it actually is Carl Johans. That's what I thought. I don't know, I use English tracks, so I don't have your problem.
What was it they say every time you kill an enemy? Whenever you kill an enemy in battle, they always, like, they're always saying something. It's like, enemy neutralized, enemy destroyed, or something.
What about it?
Well, it's funny, because in the original, they say, enemy crushed.
Oh.
Like, whoever uses the word crushed for it.
That's interesting. Oh, that's also another really great thing about the anime, too. Because you know, all the minor characters that have barely have any voice acting in there, you know, they're like enemy neutralized, whatever. Like they're actually shown in the anime as like full fledged characters with their personalities and like with voice acting, and it's so cool. I don't know.
Gotta be these. Right. Yes, the voice acting is really good, but I'm saying you had that in the game.
I'm just saying there. You now actually see them in action, like Suzy, like how she is interacting with other characters in the anime, and that's like, pure fan service. It's just awesome.
There's more of them. That's cool.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm really enjoying the anime at this point. I'm at episode 18. Metal Gear Campaign.
Yeah.